δύσκολο. The reason why we are made is to worship, nothing else. God has not made us to make billions of pounds. He has not made us to wear beautiful clothes. He will provide for those anyway. But the only thing we owe him is worship. He said, for his pleasure we were made. For his pleasure we are and we were made. Amen.
Amen.
Put your hands together. He shall divide to us our own inheritance. When you clap, you are activating your inheritance.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
You shall not miss out on your own inheritance in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Right, prepare the way of the Lord.
decir gracias a Dios.
Praise God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's time for a short exhortation, then after which the mind will be open for everybody to glorify God. You are welcome to sing in your own local dialects. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
Praise the Lord. I welcome every one of us once again, and those of us who are coming for the first time. It's nice to have you. I'm
very excited.
Amen.
Amen.
And once again, I want to appreciate everyone here. We appreciate the BAF Fellowship. We appreciate our brethren from Mountain of Fire. We appreciate our brother from the Gideon Bible Ministry. We appreciate our sister from All Nations. We give thanks to the Lord for having you with us to encounter the wonders of praise with us this month. And we're also enjoining you to keep the date for next month. It's always the last 5 days of the month, 7 to 9. This same place is the venue until God moves us to wherever He wants to. Amen.
Amen.
We were looking at the topic, we said, flee the wrath to come in the book of Revelation. Those of us who have been following, we are trusting that God will not make us part of the wrath to come. A wrath, as we always say, is coming upon.
Yeah, that's free Bible.
Free Bible. I think I need one too, sir. So that's free Bible. God bless you. God bless you, sir. So we're looking at the topic, flee the wrath to come. We're trusting that God will help us to escape the wrath that is coming upon this unto us generation. Now, I always say this, and we're in Revelation. So today we should be looking at Revelation chapter 3. Praise the Lord. So like I said, a wrath is coming upon this earth. And there is no amount of prayer that prayer warriors can pray that will avert it. And that was why Jesus Christ came in the book of Revelation. It was an impromptu, they well understood it. Because Jesus Christ never promised to come until the time he will come to rapture us. He never promised that he will come before the rapture. But if we read last month, we went back to chapter 1. Because I just discovered that this was an impromptu. It was not what God planned before. But why did it come? It came because the church was going down the drain. It was like everything that Jesus Christ labored for all his life was going down the drain. The church was nothing to write home about. And if we look at what he said about the churches there, and the churches, our church now, look at your life, look at my life. We have not done half of what those churches did. But yet, to every one of them, apart from one, he said, I have this against you. There was even one of them that he said, you have a name to be alive, but you are dead. So as much as God is concerned, that church is no longer a church. And they were running crusade, they were doing everything, holding microphone to preach. So that church, as far as everyone is concerned, is no longer in God's agenda. Or maybe phasing out of God's agenda. Amen.
Amen.
So when looking at this, because we want to believe God and trust Him to help us not to be part of that wrath that is coming upon this earth. Amen.
Amen.
So the Bible made it known to us in chapter 1. We won't go back to chapter 1. That it is what God has determined. And it was Jesus Christ said to John, it must. So it's a must. No agent can change it. Even Jesus cannot change it. But why Jesus came? Bible says the revelation that God gave to Jesus and Jesus gave to John to pass to us. So, because God saw, said, Jesus Christ, Son, what I sent you to the world to labor for, we are going to lose out if we don't take action.
That's why he came. He never promised to come before the rapture. He never promised to come. He only told us that he will come and gather the elect. See, where in my father's house, there are many mansions. Where I am, you will be. That's what he said. He never said he will come to pack him. Amen.
Amen.
God will help us in Jesus' name. So as we begin to look at things, let us begin to check ourselves. Because when we talk about church, like I said last month, if they ask the church to contribute money to buy a van, who contributes the money? It is you and I, not the building. If we're going for evangelism, if the church is going for evangelism, we will not carry the building to go and preach to people. It is you and me that will go and preach. So when Jesus Christ is referring to the church, he's here, we have to take it personal. That is why at the point, after sending the messages to the churches, he still said one thing. He that art and ear. He didn't say the church that art and ear. It is you and I who art and ear. Amen. So we're looking, we have seen something that he said he disliked in chapter 2. I think we didn't finish chapter 2, but we're going to chapter 3 because it's all about the churches for now. Remember he said John should write the things he saw, which were the 7 and the 12 and the 7 candlesticks. And the one that walks in the midst of the candlesticks. The candlesticks were the churches. The stars, the 7 stars, were the angels that were above the churches. Mainly the pastors then, the general overseers then, the bishop then, or whoever they are. I don't know what their post is. And then, he was the one that walked in the midst of the churches. That's why he said, I know your work. Nothing is hidden from him. He walks in the midst of the candlestick. So whatever goes on within the candlestick is open to him. Amen. We cannot hide anything from Christ. The church cannot pretend. And there was one thing I said last month. You can hide from everybody. You cannot hide from God, and you cannot hide from Satan. Satan knows you more than you know yourself. Amen. So you cannot hide from those two entities. But we trust God that he will help us to appropriate our lives to the standard of heaven. Amen.
Amen.
So from verse 3, he said, and unto the angel of the church in Sardis write, this thing said he that hath the 7 spirits of God and the 7 stars, I know thy works, that thou hast a name that thou livest and art dead. This is a church of God. So to every human being that look at this church, that evaluate this church was up and doing. That's why they have the name that they are living. It is not a church that the world can write off. They were up to the standard. The church was up to the standard, up to what the world, the requirement of the world. Maybe the pastor was dining with the queens, the kings of them, of the president, the authority. But we have some men of God that they are close to presidents, they are close to governors. So maybe this church, maybe the overseer of this church is worse in that hierarchy. Influential, having lots of affluence, you know. A rich church. Church that when you go to, you say, well, no. Even when God is not there, you say, I can feel the presence of God. Yeah, there are churches like that. When God is not there, but when you see, when you enter and see physical edifice, you say, God is here. God is not there. Amen.
Amen.
God will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So this church was a church like that, having a name to be alive, but as far as Christ is concerned, it's a dead church. A church that is up and doing, running, putting programs together, running crusades, doing hour of praise like we're doing here, carry microphone as I carry microphone. Even their microphone is better than this one. Very expensive one. Maybe. When they host to say like this, maybe people will come from far and wide, far and near. But as far as everyone is concerned, all those are just exercises that has no eternal value. Amen. God will deliver us in Jesus' name. Satan will not deceive us. We will not get to heaven and we will not be among the people that when they get to heaven, they will tell them that after all you have done, you have nothing here. After all that we have done, we don't belong here. We will not be among those living in Jesus' name. So I read, I continue, and he said, from verse 2, he said, be watchful and strengthen the things which remain, that they are ready to die, for I have not found thy works perfect before God. Let's note one thing. Jesus Christ never said the church was lazy. They were working. That's why he said, I know their work. Otherwise, he would have said, I know your laziness. He never said they were lazy. So they were doing things. They were printing tracts. They were doing things. They were going out. Otherwise, the church would not be filled if they don't go out to bring to win souls. But as far as heaven is concerned, that church was a gone church. Amen. So he said, remember therefore how thou hast received and had, and hold fast and repent. If therefore thou shalt not watch, I will come on thee as a thief, and thou shalt not know what hour I will come upon thee. Thou hast a few names, even in Sardis, which have not defiled their garments, and they shall walk with me in white, for they are worthy. Praise the Lord. Now, we're talking about churches and we're talking about ourselves. Jesus Christ said the church was a dead church. But yet, in that dead church, there are living souls. He said, nevertheless, there are some people among them, right inside that same church, that still do the will of God. They still do what God wants. They refuse to follow what the man of God is doing that is contrary to God. They don't follow. Some years ago, I spoke to a friend of mine because something was happening and I knew. Now, we're not set to be anybody's judge. God has not appointed us judges over anybody. But I knew that what the man of God was doing was wrong. But because the way we revere men of God in Africa. These brothers, two of them, they were my students. I was teaching them music. One on bass and one on hip hop. Both of them wanted to go the way of the pastor. I said to them, if your pastor chose to go to hellfire, will you follow him because he's your pastor? Then they thought. I tell you, the pastor came to me. And I saw some sober reflection. Now, I wasn't anybody, but probably, maybe because nobody has told him that what he was doing was not okay. He came to me and said some things to me that made me to know that this man is ready to follow God. So sometimes, because the way we respect our leaders, when they are wrong, we find it difficult to correct them, and they keep on believing what they were doing is right. For that man to come to me, he was not my mate. Age-wise, I'm not anywhere near him. And even in the ministry, he was a pastor of a church. I have no church. But he came in humility. Maybe he knew that that statement was from me. Probably they told him that this man said you are going to hell. I don't know what made him to come to me and make those words he made. And he changed. He changed. Amen. He changed. There were some properties he seized, which he restored back to the owner. Amen. 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 So, as far as this is concerned, as far as heaven is concerned, we're talking about churches and we're talking about our individual lives. So, even if the environment we find ourselves is corrupt, we can stand. We can decide. Bible told us of Daniel. The environment that Daniel was not a palatable environment to serve God. It was not. Everything around them was from the king.
Jesus is the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Shalom.
Praise the Lord.
Everything around them was royal. Everything around them was prayer. And that was the only thing available to them, and that was the only option they had. Even if they wanted to serve God, they live in that palace, they live in that place, and they work there because they chose them among the exile, if you remember. They chose them among the exile and trained them to serve the king. So they are being prepared for that. But he proposed, remember Isaiah. Bible told us of Isaiah that when King Uzziah died, Isaiah saw the Lord. Mm. People say Isaiah is a demon, he's a wicked king. Uzziah was not a wicked king. It was true that he fell apart from God towards the end of his life. But Uzziah was a very nice king, one of the best kings that Judah ever had. And I believe that the reason why Isaiah did not see God before Uzziah died was because everything was too palatable for him. So when he was supposed to fast, he was not fasting. That man was his uncle, and that man was a very nice man. So the man was not a demon like we look at him, that he was blocking Isaiah. He didn't block Isaiah. Isaiah was one that was not serious. By my own understanding, that man was a very nice man. At the end of his life, like I said, he went away from God. And God was annoyed with him. God smote him. But it was not Isaiah's problem. Isaiah was enjoying the beauty, the benefit of the palace. That's what I believe. Amen. But now, for Daniel was in that same circumstances. He found himself in that same circumstance. But he proposed not to defile himself with the things of the king. If Isaiah had done that, he would have seen the Lord long time. Amen. So, even if the environment we find ourselves is corrupt, we can decide to serve God. We can. Your church may be against God, but you can be for God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. So, we're going to... Amen. So, like I said, thou hast a few names even in Sardis, which have not defiled their garments. So that church, according to Christ, was a dead church. Even though the church has a name that was named, the church looked so glamorous to the eye of man. Everybody commended the church, applauded the church. Oh, you know, right on, pastor. When pastor is preaching, right on, pastor. Carry on, carry go. But as far as everyone is concerned, it was a dead church. But yet, there were people who decided for God. Today, let's stand up for Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much.
Praise the Lord.